The surface of our planet is mostly covered in water, and yet there's still so much we don't know about what's below. A majority of the seafloor remains unexplored, and there are likely countless undiscovered life forms swimming in the depths. Technology has allowed researchers to finally dive into the dark, however, into high-pressure environments to see what lies below, and they've made some very strange discoveries along the way. This is Unveiled, and today we're taking an extraordinary look at four of the most bizarre discoveries in the deep sea.
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
With billions of years worth of life and thousands of years worth of human artifacts, the Earth sure holds a lot of secrets. Even today, we're still discovering new species of plant and animal as the diversity of this planet continues to astound. In the years 2014 and 2015, 381 new species were discovered in the Amazon rainforest alone. Speaking of the Amazon, in 2022, researchers announced that they had used digital mapping to uncover the ruins of urban settlements previously hidden in the jungle. We took a closer look in another recent video, so be sure to check that out after this. In short, there is still plenty for scientists to uncover on land, but still, the oceans remain even more mysterious. We know that the seafloor holds many secrets, but these are some of the strangest ocean oddities that we've found so far. Built in 1903, the RMS Republic, nicknamed the Millionaire's Ship, was considered unsinkable. In 1909, however, 3 years before the Titanic left port, the Republic was struck by another ship and promptly sank beneath the waves. At the time, it was the largest ship to ever have sunk. A distress call sent out using newly invented wireless telegraph technology allowed the crew and passengers to escape, but the ship itself plummeted to the bottom of the ocean. The wreck lay there undisturbed for 70 years until, in 1981, the treasure hunter Captain Martin Baierli finally found it on the seafloor, 50 miles south of Nantucket Island, Massachusetts. This might not seem too bizarre, but the treasure it carried is where it gets interesting. At the time of its sinking, the ship was reportedly loaded with a wealth of valuables. That included a quarter of a million gold coins for the U.S. Navy, thousands of dollars for the survivors of an earthquake in Italy, a fortune in personal jewelry, and a 5-ton shipment of American Gold Eagle coins worth $3 million. And that's their worth at 1909 standards. In today's money, we're talking a lot more. Altogether, the estimated fortune exceeds $1 billion in today's economy, with some people valuing its goods at a whopping $7 billion total. And yet, it largely remains unclaimed. We know or suspect that it's there, but no one has ever actually gotten their hands on it. A few problems present themselves for aspiring treasure hunters heading for the Republic. As the ship was considered unsinkable, it's fair to say that it's a sturdy structure. Not only is the cargo likely to have moved around on the ship then, but actually getting to it would involve excavating thousands of tons worth of ship deck. Really, you'd have to know precisely where the gold was, a near impossibility, in order to reach it. Although despite the issues, wreck finder Martin Baierli reportedly remains committed to retrieving the treasure one day. But it's not just ships that are difficult to salvage from the bottom of the ocean. That's also true of the giant spine that was purportedly spotted at the bottom of the Mediterranean Sea. In 2017, an unnamed worker from an oil and gas company was operating a remotely controlled underwater vehicle in order to photograph sections of the seafloor when he captured footage of something extraordinary. Having done this job for many years, he was familiar with the types of creatures in the area and their anatomy, but he couldn't explain what marine animal would have left a spine that measured around 30 meters, 98 feet in length. The first thing that came to mind was, unsurprisingly, some kind of whale. But that also doesn't seem likely, because it was missing a skull. And whales have large and heavy skulls that are altogether unlikely to go missing. Plus, the spine didn't match what we'd usually expect. Whales have 3 blades on their vertebrae, whereas the snaking spine at the bottom of the Med only has 2. Scientists, oceanographers, biologists, anyone and everyone was stumped. After paranormal investigator Deborah Hatswell shared the footage on YouTube, no one could reliably say what it was. Despite its serpentine look, it's been deemed probably not an oarfish, considering the fact that this skeleton was some 4 times larger than the biggest oarfish ever found. What's more, when the unnamed worker tried to interact with the skeleton by picking it up, it crumbled into dust, meaning it might also have been ancient, Given its enormous size and its placement in the Mediterranean, there was naturally one direction that the story took. In the minds of some, this unusual find brings to mind the many legends of giant sea serpents that sailors so often wrote about in the past. Could this be the skeleton of one such ancient monster, or a dinosaur? So far, the footage has yet to be examined by a professional, but the intrigue has grown and grown. Some underwater formations, on the other hand, have been meticulously studied by professionals, like the Yonaguni Monument. The Yonaguni Monument is a certainly strange underwater rock structure discovered by a diver in 1986 next to Yonaguni Island in Japan. It's famous because marine geologist Masaki Kimura, along with several pseudo-archaeology writers, claimed that it was man-made. Kimura argues that the area as a whole is up to 3,000 years old, and that in its entirety, the monument includes detailed structures like pyramids, roads, and even a stadium. He believes it could actually be the lost continent of Mu, often identified alongside and even paired with Atlantis. There's little doubt that at first glance, this is a spectacular place. There are sections where the rocks are shaped in such a way that they even seem to resemble staircases. And it isn't too difficult to imagine a time when people might have walked them. Other geologists, however, believe that the Yonaguni formations have a different and more grounded explanation, that they're really the result of natural processes. The parallel lines are said to be common features of bedding plains, created when sediment is laid out in distinct layers over time. And the crisscrossing lines that can also be seen could be natural fractures that have formed due to earthquakes in the region. The supposed markings in the area that some claim may have also been man-made are really just random but natural scratches in the rock. Notably, Yonaguni skeptics include the Japanese government, which doesn't recognize the monument as an important landmark. But finally, perhaps one of the most bizarre discoveries ever made at the bottom of the ocean is so strange precisely because it's one of the last things you would expect to find on the seafloor. Fields of metal balls have been spotted in the Pacific, Atlantic, and Indian Oceans. They're a global sight then, and can sometimes cover 70% of any given portion of the seafloor. Called manganese nodules, the structures are thought to form when metal ore gradually collects around a core such as a rock or fossil. Again, they perhaps look as though they should be artificial, but actually, they're not. Oceans are littered with the formations, which can be as small as a pebble or as large as a bowling ball. It's thought that the nodules grow extremely slowly, as little as 1 centimeter in a million years. But there are two major mysteries surrounding the balls. For one, they only seem to exist on the seafloor and not buried below it. But that's odd because there should be many that get naturally buried over time. For another, their rate of growth really is astonishingly slow. Even the slowest sedimentation rate that scientists know about is 10 times faster than these manganese nodules. Animals and ocean currents could be playing a part in their mysteries, but no one really knows why there are so many of them out there. There have been attempts to mine these fields to extract nickel from the nodules, although those attempts have also been criticized by environmental groups. Overall, the bottom of the ocean is one of the most mysterious places on Earth. What's your verdict? What's the greatest ocean mystery you know of? In addition to a majority of it never having even been seen, there are a lot of fascinating things that have been found in the areas of the sea that we have set eyes on. On top of those featured in this video, divers and explorers have discovered train graveyards, ancient Greek computing devices, engines from the Apollo space missions, and even underwater rivers. Most of these can be explained, however, and so perhaps aren't quite as bizarre as the objects that people still can't fully describe. Looking ahead, there are undoubtedly many more mysteries to be found. Quite apart from anything else, there's likely an enormous amount of undiscovered life down there, as well as long-buried artifacts waiting to be unearthed in the deepest depths. Until then, those are four of the most bizarre discoveries in the deep sea. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.